Hey guys, Kaja here and welcome back to another diecast review. Now first of all, before we actually get into anything on the video, this is completely unrelated to it. There seems to be construction going on behind my house, as you can probably hear, which is extremely annoying because I'm at the back of my garden in the little sort of room, you could call it. I'll have to show you guys around in a video. And I've literally, this is the third video I've done down here, first being Brian Sparks' video, and they're doing construction. Like, what bad time? And I haven't used like this room down here. You see what I mean? I literally haven't used this room down here ever for recording. I decide to do so, and there is literally construction going on. So we'll try and work our way around it. Hopefully you guys can't hear it too much as I can, because I know obviously it's far away from the microphone. But it is a pretty good microphone on this phone. Really? It literally sounds like they're right behind. I mean, they technically are, but there's a road. It's like a water reserve, so it's not even like houses or anything. It's literally some sort of water thing or something. Like, I don't really know. But anyway, today we are reviewing next gen. Oh my god, stop. Please stop. Right, we are reviewing next gen N20 Cola HJ Hollis. As you can see, I've got Manny Flywheel and, oh, what's his name? Parker Braxton, there we go. Got it in the end. The 2016 stock car, I should say. And Manny Flywheel, who is the original Cars 1 version. So we will move on to them two later when we come to comparing them. Before I get into anything else, just tell me down in the comments which one is your favourite. So I'll just quickly bring them back. Which one is your favourite? Mine is either Manny or HJ. I'm not too sure because Manny's got more purple. Purple and green are two colours I really like. Whereas Parker, I don't know, his colour's nicer in real life than it is on camera. But I don't know. And also links to, I will put a little card up somewhere, you'll see it somewhere here on the top of the screen. So you, if you haven't seen my review on Parker Braxton, you can go do so. And I may make a review on Manny in the future. Anyway, so today we're going to be reviewing HJ Hollis. He is the 2017 next gen car for N20 Cola. He first appeared when the next gen started to come in. I can't quite remember if he was one of the first or anything, but that's where he was first appearanced and or first shown. I don't know if appearance is a word. And he was seen at the Florida 500 also. So he is probably, I'd say probably one of my favourite next gens to be released. Like I said, I really like the colour purple and green, especially this green. It is really nice colour. I love his spoiler as well. I think it's a unique spoiler that no next gen has had so far. And I'm not sure if I actually saw many others with this spoiler, so it's very cool that they are, you know, Mattel are actually mixing it up for once. I found this in a store, or should I more correctly say my parents found this in a store, and it was actually the Disney store, which is a big surprise. But sadly they didn't have a Herb Kerbler there, because there are Herb Kerbler and Ryan Inside Laney are the last two 2017 singles that I need, and I've completely got them all. So that was a bit of a shame they didn't have them, but HJ Hollis is probably my favourite out of the three. So it was cool that they had him. Also, then there's a new picture by, I think, VT Cars 31 of his, I think that's his name. Sorry if I got it wrong, but a picture on RC Cars 5 community of new 2018 singles, and they're actually found in Greece, if you guys didn't know that. And the good thing for me is I'm going to Greece in about a month and a bit, about roughly 2 months. So hopefully they'll obviously have those cars out there when I go, so I'll be able to get new cars and review them for you. So that'll be really cool. I was really excited to see that it was in Greece that they were found. It is such an unusual place though to find them. Anyway, I think we should probably get into the actual review of HJ, because he hasn't appeared anywhere else in the film. So let's just get on to the actual physical review of him. So he follows the same body shape as Danny Suarez, the more bigger and square shape. Is that really a plane? It's actually a plane now as well. Anyway, as we go into the front, we have these two vents here, very nicely placed. I think I'm just going to turn on the light for better lighting for you guys. Is that... I don't know if that's too bright. No, that's good. So yeah, he's the same body shape as Dan Swell, as I said, and he has his vents here. He's got sort of an angry, very much determined expression, like a focused expression as well. He's like, just doesn't want anyone else to bother him, just wants to do his thing and win the race. Oh, some clicking going on there. We can see his sort of moustache grill is very sleek, goes right into the light, so you can tell that's a next-gen sort of grill there. It's very, very cool. Quite a basic N2O Cola logo, because a lot of the next-gen's logos are basic, but that's sort of modern design. No more really like funky writing like that, or years ago when they were cartoony-like. It's just kind of basic now, but they seem to always follow the same sort of the colour pattern and the colour scheme, but they're just very basic. He's got black wheels here with a next-gen style light year writing. You can see that there. We have his contingency sponsors, being the Piston Cup, obviously, Combustor, Carbon Cyber and Synergy. Now we have the stock car Synergy Racer and we have the stock car Combustor. We don't have any Carbon Cyber cars yet, but the stock car is coming out later this year, I believe, along with Combustor's next gen, I think, and I don't think we're getting a Synergy. Oh no, I think we are in a double pack with next gen Lil Talky Piston, which is actually a female, which is pretty cool. As you can see here, your N2O and Cola, although Cola comes before, so you obviously read from left to right, so you read it as Cola, N2O, so that's very weird. And once again, we've got the basic 68, which does look very cool. You can see there's all different colours as well, like a darker, lighter purple, and then the green. They've got the little arrow to indicate his pit crew where to lift him up. With a square, he's got his square exhaust there too, and his fuel cap there. You can see more of the patterns here. So it splits off on there. This, you'd actually think that looks like an error just near the fuel cap, but it's actually not. It's on both sides. So it's just part of his pattern. We have his roof flaps here and 68 as well. We have the obviously black tire again. And as we go to the back, we have his rookie stripes there, or sort of rookie squares with the N2O Cola and 68. Something they also do with the next gen is they're swapping around what way they do the number, or at least they are with the stock car and the next gen anyway, so maybe the next gens have them all on that side, I can't quite remember. And we have a sort of like, I don't know why they did that again, it's a bit like JP Drive, the next gen Apple racer. He has that. He has this exact same design. It's on the Apple on the Disney Store one, which I will probably be my next review if you guys want to see that. So I don't know why they do this here. It's just like a rear grille. I've never seen that before. As we go to his wing there, you can see a very cool sleek design, a very nice purple. And you can see N2O Cola. The green is very nice. His design is the same on the other side, just flipped, so it's not back to front. Very cool design though, indeed. The paint here, as you can see, the paint sort of never quite, you can never quite get it on. Yeah, it's very weird. There we go. See, it's now flush with a wheel arch. It's not sticking out. The base is quite boring, just flat. You've got his diffuser, which was sort of first in designed on the Cars 2 sort of races. That's what this all, the bases always remind me of like the World Grand Prix races. But we just have the codes there and the Made in China, Disney, Pixar, Mattel, and all that regular stuff. There we go, let me just focus back in. All right, and so now let's compare him first to the original, as you can see here, Manny Flywheel. Now, I've always got a problem with Manny Flywheel because his actual body shape in the movie doesn't actually look like this. It actually goes up and then down again, like you'd expect on a Nitro sort of body shape, but it's not the same. It's like a mix between the two, but they did it like this, so I don't know why one car out of all of them would have a different body shape, so that always surprised me, but obviously they just released them like this. I'm not going to go into too much depth about him because I'll probably do a review in the future, but I'm just going to compare. So you can see, as you can see, very different on the front there in terms of designs. We've got a lot of like fluorescent yellow on here, sort of yellowy green color, so it's very different from what we have now. It's almost pure green. To the side we have sort of a yellowy design which goes little pinstripe that goes down, which has completely changed. The 68 is also now square and solid white, and whereas the other is black, yellow and white, so it's got multiple colours to it. The locations where the numbers aren't the same either, or the logos along with the back, none of it is the same. So there's pretty much nothing you can compare on here. This is only full of differences. So you might be able to have a few more similarities with Manny Flywheel. No, not Manny Flywheel, but Parker Brakeson. The Intero Colo, again, is different. This is also different to Manny Flywheel. As we go over to the front, we have a bit of green here, which is not really similar again. 68, which is different. Back, different again. There is actually nothing you can compare to on here apart from show you the difference. If we more look at these two cars, you can see there's more similarity in the numbers. This is just more shadowy and less yellow. And it's more green now as well. The logo has been redesigned. So let's just put them in order. So once again, what one is your favourite out of the three? I'd say it either to be Manny or HJ Hollis, but I'm not entirely sure. This is probably the biggest redesign in a sponsor. How it's gone, we've literally gone from this to what we have now, completely different. But I suppose some companies do completely change the design of them. I personally think, I suppose it is quite cool that they've done this, but it is good to still be able to recognise a company, what it looks like, because you could completely think that was a different racer, but it's still cool nonetheless. And yeah, I think that is pretty much about it for the N2O Cola racers. If we move these two out of the way and we just bring HJ Hollis back here. Right, that is pretty much it. A bit of a shorter video, but I hope you guys did enjoy nevertheless. That is all I've got to say. Thank you for the support of my videos again. Really do appreciate it. We're up to 280 subscribers now, and we just hit 70,000 views yesterday, which is crazy. So let's see if we can keep this going. So that's all I have to say. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, and I will see you in the next review.